In this video, I'm gonna show you how you can download FreeCamp 8 on your laptop. And FreeCamp 8 is used to record your screen, and it also has some editing feature in it. I can also use it to clean up your sound. This is the link right here. I'm gonna put it in my description so they can easily download it. So let's get right into it. Go ahead and click on the link. Once you click on the link, it opens up. Now in this box right here, this is where we're going to type in our email address. So go ahead and put in your email address, then click on download. Without it, you won't be able to download it. So you need to put in your email address and click on download. So while it's downloading, let me give you some quick information about FreeCamp. What is FreeCamp 8? FreeCamp is a video recording software designed to create screen recording, edit video, and publish them to YouTube. You can use the audio/video editing tools to trim specific sections from the video, remove background noise, adjust volume, and add a fade in and out effect. And that's not all. You can also record voiceover with the microphone and align the mouse cursor as it moves across the screen with FreeCamp. It also allows you to record the entire screen or specific area of the screen or a single window to create a video lesson and e-learning presentation. Now you need to listen to this side. FreeCamp enables users to save recording in 720p resolution and upload it to YouTube. It is a no-cost software, but there's also the paid version which has some extra feature, but the free one is pretty cool too. So let's get right into it. Now that's one of the information you need to know about FreeCamp. Let's come over here and click on that arrow. Once you click on that arrow, click on open. Yep, once it opens up, that is the what we downloaded. Just click on it and wait for it to install. So the installation process have started. This is right here. Keep on waiting. Okay, so now we have this. Now you need to read the terms and conditions so that you agree to it. You don't want you agreeing to. So go ahead and click on this dot right here. Once you click on it, you'll be able to click on continue. If not, you won't be able to continue. So do read the terms and condition. Click on continue. So after clicking on continue till start installing, this might take a couple of minutes to complete. One of the reasons why I like FreeCamp is the ability to edit the audio. Okay, so it's done installing. Go ahead and click on launch to launch the application. So let's just give it a couple of minutes for that to be done. After downloading it, we're going to come right here. You can see the application here, FreeCamp 8. Click on it. So wait for it to open up. So this is it right here. This is where you click when you want to start recording your screen, new recording. If you have some old recording you have done that you want to check, it just come here. You can click on here. Once you click on it, it opens a new window which contains where the videos are being stored. You can see it here, recording. So let's click on it, open it up, and you can see right here. So this is a recording I've done already. So let's close this. You can see some of the recordings already. So right here it says update. You can update the application if you want to up here. They can read about it, then help. So let's go ahead and record the video right now. So click on new. So this is how it looks when you're recording. You notice you can adjust this. It's adjustable. So if you want to do like a vertical video, like for TikTok, you can easily do that. Boom. Then just move it to where you want it to be. Wow, that's pretty good. Then if you want a full screen, now come down here to capture size. This is how you can change the size. So come down here to this arrow right here. This is for capture size. So you can have full screen, you can have video. We are at this video length, our video size is 4.3. they can have a video of 16:9, basically that's YouTube. We can have a full screen, select the area, select application right here. Okay, so if I want a full screen, I just click here and boom, just cover the whole screen right here. I can see here the length times the breadth, so I can see how wide it is. So come right here to the settings. This is where the settings is. Click. So you can make adjustments from here. You can set off microphone. You can pause result. So basically what you do here, you can change the key. So right now the F9 key can pause and resolve, then stop recording. If I click on the escape key, I can stop the recording. Then if I come right here and click on F10, I can restart the recording. So that's simple way to do it. Then if you see, it says record system sound and it's clicked. So the system sound is being recorded when I click on things or icons, get recorded. You come over here to advanced. So right here on advanced, we can see it says open new windows inside a recording area, show system tray icon, and show mouse cursor. Now, if you click on this, this will make a yellow little round circle appear on the cursor right here. The cursor will have that on it. So let's click OK. We're okay with that. So this is where we can see the mute. We can mute the mic here. If I click mute and release it. So this is for recording, to start the recording right here. So I'm going to start the recording now. Let me bring this, reduce it. So I don't want a full screen. I want this. Okay, let's make it, bring it down like this. So I'm gonna show you how this will look later on. So let's record it. So right now the recording has started and it's on my icons, on my folders, icons of the applications, that's where I'm recording. Right here, you can see this, it says delete and start over again. So if you don't like what you're recording, you could just click here to restart the recording again. Or if you do like it and you're done, just come over here and click on finish recording. That's where you're gonna click on to finish the recording. So I'm just gonna click on it now. Done. So now it says preparing preview. Now depending on the size of the of your video, depending on the length of your video, this could take a couple of minutes to 5 minutes, up to 10, depending on the length of your video. This video is very short, so just quickly process it. So once you get here, that says upload to YouTube. You can upload straight to YouTube. You can save as a video file. Then new recording over here. Then you can click help if you need help. Now you can click this arrow here. And we have new recording. We have open project, save project, save project as. Okay. And can also export it. So basically to export it, we can only export, save the screen recorder, recorder to your disk in WMV format. So this is the format, or you can just choose to upload it to YouTube if you want to export it out. Now let's come over to edit, so we can edit this video in the screen recorder app itself. So click on edit. So now we wait for it to open up. Okay, it's opened up. Let me increase the screen size. go ahead. Okay, so the screen size has been increased, full screen now. So now let's go into, let's talk about more about the editing feature in FreeCamp. So we know that we can edit the audio, we can also feed it in and out, and some of the other little features we can do with it. It's not that much, but it's the basic, like especially the noise remover, that is very important when you're editing your video. You really want to make the sound clear. So let me show you how you can use that and other feature in the editing, a feature in the application. YouTube Shorts.
You can see right here. Nicely done. Okay, so we have our video right here. Let's edit it a bit. Right here, we can remove noise. To do that, all we need to do is pick the noisy area in the video, like this. Then we come back here and click here. Once you click here, you can see it says select a part of your recording that contains only background noise. Okay, so we need something just like this. Something just like this. That's step one. And step two, the noise selected in the previous step will be removed throughout the entire recording. Okay, that is pretty nice. So after we have done picking the noisy area, then we'll come back and click a light everywhere. Then click on remove noise. You can see right here, it was re-lighted again. Okay, so let me go ahead and pick a particular area that I feel was noisy. Let's come here. Let's play this.
Oh, so right now the recording has started.
Okay. So let's play. I'm gonna pick this area. So let me increase it. Let's increase it. So you can increase the video by coming right here, then move it over. I think you can do it from your mouse too. Just roll, if you have a little round ball on your mouse, you can just move that. So let's roll in. Let's increase it. So let's look for that. Okay. So I'm gonna choose right here. Then come over here. So I've done the first part. Click remove noise. And you can see automatically the rest of the other side were unlighted and the noise is being removed. Wow. Yeah, you can see the difference now. It's much thinner. Look at here. Okay, let's bring this back down. All this. A bit. So let's play it. Let's see how it sounds like.
To right now, the recording has started and it's on my iCloud or my folder.
Okay. The sound sounds much better now. And that's not all you can do. You can also adjust the volume from here. You can adjust the volume. You can increase it more if you want to. You can also fade in, fade out. You can show all or zoom in. If you want to zoom in, all you need to do is just highlight the part. Then you notice it's not active. You can now click on this to zoom in. And also you can trim if you want any part of the video. You can say here, delete all except the current selection. So, which means that only the parts you selected will remain, while the remaining part, like here and here, will be deleted from the from this track. Okay, so right here we can delete current selection, silence, insert a silence into the current selection if you want that. Now to save, we can also save and close. So it does have a lot of features too. Okay, so let's go ahead and save. Okay, click here. Then we can change the name from the default name. Let's change it to Free Camp 8. Then I'm gonna change my desktop. Okay. Then click on Save. And that's it, guys. So that's how easy to use Free Camp. So let me close this. So this is video right here. So then click on this, click on it. So let's open up. So this is, guys. So this is the video, and this is how you can create with radical video in Free Camp. You can even create a full screen video. And taking note of what I was talking about right here, you notice that my cursor have a yellow circle around it, which helps me when I'm trying to point out a particular item. When I'm talking about a particular item, it shows where my mouse is. So look at it. Okay, so that's how you can use Free Camp. Thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, please go ahead and subscribe for more videos like these. I'm also going to put the link to this application in my description, so go ahead and check there for it. Bye.